Hi everybody, my name's Tim Gresh. I'm a professional bike fitter in Westchester, Pennsylvania. This video will be on cleat float. This will be the third part of my series on cleat placement. I already did two previous videos. First one on cleat position fore and aft, and then the other one was on separation width. So check those out if you have not. But this right here will be on float. It's sort of the last adjustment that you can make to your cleats on your cycling shoes. Now, to start off, let's talk about what float is. First thing is, do not get it confused with spring tension. So spring tension would be typically an adjustment screw on your pedal that will adjust the amount of tension needed to unclip. This is not float, it's just purely how hard it is to unclip, okay? Float is different. Float is the amount of movement that your foot can make in terms of a rotation on the pedal, like heel in and heel out. This is measured in degrees. So that's what float is. Now, why is float important? It's important because it keeps the knee healthy. That's kind of the bottom line. And here's why. So stick figure of a leg, we've got the foot, the knee, and the hip. Now, if we think about the body has three planes of motion that it will move in. The foot will move in three planes, all three planes, there's just three planes of motion. So the foot will move in all three. The knee primarily just moves in one plane of motion. The hip will move in three, okay? So this is what keeps, for the most part, a healthy knee. When the foot can move in all three, the hip can move in all three, and your knee can kind of work through that because the knee is sort of trapped in between these two mobile joints and just kind of works in one plane, sort of like a hinge joint, a little bit like your elbow. Now, if we did not have float, we would actually reduce the movement to about one plane of motion in the foot with cleats with no float. So that what that would do is cause injury to the knee because the knee kind of requires the other two planes of motion down here in order to work properly. So really not a good thing to not have float. So we need to have this three down here. So just to kind of illustrate the implications of having float and not having float. Now, with that said, what are some of my recommendations for you in terms of float for your pedals and also cleat setup? First thing would be, as you can expect, do not use fixed cleats. A fixed cleat is a cleat that has no float in it at all, and these actually do exist. So for example, Look Keo cleats that are black, those have no float. So what that means is that if you had that cleat on your shoe, you went to clip in, your foot would not have any heel in or heel out movement. It would just be stuck in one spot. Also, Shimano road pedals in the red cleats, those are also fixed. Other brands will have their equivalent, so definitely avoid cleats with zero float. You want to go for the cleats with float. Now, how much float do I recommend? This ultimately comes down to your bike fitter to help you determine. There's a lot of factors that go into it. It's sort of hard for me to sort of advise remotely, but I think generally speaking, you want to have float between about 4.5 degrees and 12 degrees of movement. I would probably veer towards a little bit more towards the 12 than the 4.5 as a general recommendation. Now, as far as cleat setup. This will vary on the type of system that you have, whether it's a road cleat or a mountain cleat and the brand. But generally speaking, when you put the cleat on, set it in a neutral spot so that the front of the cleat and the back of the cleat, you can kind of run a line through that and it will intersect the forefoot and the heel. That's sort of a good neutral setup that'll give you about an equal amount of side to side float because you want to have the ability for your heel to kind of move out and move in towards the bike. That way your foot can more or less kind of go where it wants to go and get those three planes of motion that we described earlier. Now, I also want to just give a shout out to a few different pedal brands. So if you're watching this video and you're thinking, you know, what brand does Tim recommend? I'm gonna give my top picks here. So at the very top for a road pedal, nothing beats SPEEDPLAY. So SPEEDPLAY has, I think, a brilliant design in every way, specifically in float, because there's actually little set screws on it where you can actually dial in your float very precisely. You can actually set the amount of heel in and heel out movement. So in a way, there's no kind of guesswork in installing the cleat. You kind of install it and just sort of dial in exactly how much movement in the foot feels good to you. So I love SPEEDPLAY. The next one would be SQLab. They actually make a pedal that would use the two bolt style, kind of like your Shimano SPD. And they actually have float up to about 20 degrees, which is quite a bit, but a standard Shimano SPD only has 4.5, which is kind of on the lower end. I wish it was a little bit more than that. So SQLab, shout out to them. They have a good amount of float. Also, time pedals, not to be confused with time bikes. Time, the pedal manufacturer, they're currently owned by SRAM. They make pedals and cleats that have quite a bit of float. So their options in road and mountain are gonna give you a lot to work with there. I particularly like their off-road pedals because they're gonna give you more float than a Shimano SPD, but also be like a nice high performance pedal if you're doing like really aggressive riding, you're pulling up on the pedals really hard. So there you have it, my two cents on float. I hope you find this useful. Thanks for watching, leave comments below. I'll do my best to answer. Like and subscribe to the channel and enjoy every ride.